Hi, I'm Pierre-Nard, and today we have a desktop motherboard from Intel which doesn't turn on. This is a custom OEM motherboard which has a dedicated front panel which connects with the USB port. So we are not gonna use that, but rather the pads right here which are labeled front panel. Pin 8 and 6 are for the power button. So let's turn on the power supply. The green light comes on, but when we short those pads, as you can see, power supply doesn't turn on. So first thing we are gonna check is if our standby voltage okay. So first, standby voltage 5 volts coming from the power supply on the purple wire. You can see 5.1, perfectly fine. And the 3.3 volt standby regulator, which is right under here, you can see that. Here is our 3.3 volt standby regulator. So let's convert the 5 volt standby from the power supply to the 3.3 volt standby needed for the standard IO and the southbridge. So this one has got 3.3 volts, so it's perfect. This is an 1117 light chip, which can go bad on those desktop motherboards and in a computer display too, but here it is fine. So now we are gonna check if we have voltage on our standard IO. This is an SMSC LPC47M182. So let's switch to the datasheet. See the pinout right here. So we are interested in the VTO pin, which is the 3.3 volt power supply in the standby mode. So this one on yep, so this is on pin 76 and 93. Let's measure on the pin 93, which is right here. So we have got 3.3 volt, which is perfect. And now we are gonna check the rhythm reset signal coming from this standard IO chip, which is needed for the southbridge to start doing its job. So if we look at the pinout, the rhythm reset signal is on pin 92. So let's check that. On pin 92, you can see I got 0 volts. So this pin should go high for the source bridge to exit reset mode. If we look at the datasheet, on the rhythm reset logic, it says that it needs both VTR voltage which we have 3.3 volt and the V underscore 5PO underscore standby voltage for the rhythm reset signal to go high. So we're gonna check the V underscore 5PO underscore standby signal, which can be found on pin 71. So let's check pin 71. 60, 70, 71. So, okay, so we have got 5.1 volt right here, which should be good. According to the datasheet, it must be between higher than V-trip. They say it is shown in the figure number 26, but in reality it's 30. So this is our voltage, this is the signal we need, and they say the V underscore 5P0 underscore standby voltage need to be higher than 4.5 volts. So we have the two required voltage, but RSM reset signal doesn't show up, which means that our standard IO here must be bad. So we are gonna replace it right now. So let's unplug this. Get to soldering equipment ready. I'm gonna use hot air to remove this chip. So first I'm gonna add some flux. Before that, should remove the battery. Okay. Now we are gonna get to a temperature a bit higher. Okay. There we go. Now we are gonna clean the pads. I think my soldering iron heating element is going to die. It's not heating the pads. Okay, so here is the new chip that we are gonna put on now. Okay, I hope it's soldered on correctly. Not sure. I've got a bridge right here. Yeah, should be okay. So I'm gonna try to plug it in and see what happens. So we have still a green light. Let's measure the pins we measured before to see if we still have the same behavior. It doesn't seem right. Oh, not on the... Yep, AC will not work. So 3.3 on the regulator. No, here we still have 3.3. confirm the pinout. Check 71.5. No reason reset. What am I measuring? Here, see, VGR is 3.3 volts. And rhythm reset is now 3 volts too, so that's fine. Now, we'll try to turn it on. And nothing happens either. So that's no good. What are we missing now that we have restored rhythm reset? Check the power button input, which is can't see it. Let's check SLPS5 first. Okay, so SLPS5 is yeah, those signals are okay. So power button, which one it is? So it's probably not present on the standard IO, but only on the southbridge, I think. Okay, so for this motherboard to work, you need to plug in the CPU first. That's the first time I see your motherboard like this. You just wanted me to lose my time, I think. So let's plug in the post card. What the fuck is this port? Is it a PCI port? Yeah. This is a P4, so you don't want it to overheat. And I can't get it to fit on the CPU. Yeah. This one is better. Yeah. Okay. No. Let's use. I don't have any heatsink for this, apparently. Okay, one here. Let's grab this one. Yep. Should work. Yeah, this is better. So CPU fan. Here we go, we have all some RAM. Ooh. Let's try that. Turns on. Let's plug in the screen to this. It doesn't seem to have anything. Power on. Still doesn't work. We should have an integrated speaker right here. Okay, so that's fine. Let's try another RAM stick. This is gonna be difficult. I'm pretty sure I had one. Where did it go? We run right here. No. Those are DJ1. This one doesn't have anything. Yeah. Nope. Okay. gonna stick with that. Some contact cleaner. Which is empty. Let's try with another key card. Yeah, it doesn't do shit. So why doesn't it work? Let's try something else. Okay, so I have no idea what's going on. This postcard on the PCI Express port stops on code 50, but this doesn't mean much, so not sure what's going on. At least the BIOS is running, because when we remove the RAM stick, it beeps, but it's not posting. So I think I'm gonna investigate on this another time. Okay, so I think I was just being an idiot with that BIOS not posting, because I just saw that there is a jumper missing right here. You can see that. So right here, there is three pins, which two of them need to be jumped together for the BIOS to actually start. Because if you look at the table written on the motherboard right here, BIOS config, and when there is no jumper, it is in recovery mode, and for it to be normal mode, you need to jump in 1 and 2. So that's what we are gonna do right here. So jump 1 and 2, plug that back in. Now we have RAM, CPU, display plugged in. I'm gonna show you the screen right here. Yeah, huge latency, but it is working. So let's turn on the power supply. And as you can see, it is booting now. There is nothing plugged in to boot it, so I'm gonna plug in a neat Ethernet cable and try to boot with PXE. Not sure it works on this motherboard. So this one is a bit short, but let's see. I'm gonna do it like that. Plug that in. Okay. Find the keyboard. USB keyboard. Right here. Let's reboot. Okay, keep not rebooting. BIOS setting F2. Can it boot? Boot network enable. And yep, should be enough. What do we have? A pretty crappy CPU, only 500 megabytes of RAM. Here we go, let's try this one. Oh yeah, sorry, this webcam is already exposed, can't do anything about it. But as you can see, it's booting perfectly fine. So, yep, this is now a working motherboard, except for one thing. As you can see right here, we are missing a chip, which is the audio chip. I removed it a while ago, so here it is. It's completely shorted, so obviously I can't put it back on. And also I can't find a replacement chip. It's model number, if I think I have it. I must have... here it is. STAC9221X5. And can't find it anywhere. Anyway, it was complete crap, so that's not a big loss. And I don't think this motherboard would be ever used again. But you know, why not? Okay. So that's fixed, and see you next time.